So normalized cuts fixes this bias that min-cut has of wanting to pull off these little elements. And the way it does it is it's going to propose a cut, and it has the traditional measure of cutting A and B, but it's normalized by the association within A and the association within B. And a simple way of thinking about it is the association is just sort of how well connected, summed over all of the nodes within a segment, how well connected those points are. So the problem is if you have two segments and one is very small, it's going to have a very small value. And if that denominator becomes a small value, that whole element becomes very large. So even though the other element might be a small size, the fact that this one became small will penalize that a lot. So by doing this normalization, you can end up with a much better cut of the graph. If you just wanted to do the best end cut, normalized cut, that would be computationally prohibitive. But there is an approximate solution that exists using what's referred to as the generalized, or solving the generalized eigenvalue problem. I'll just show you a very simple, not simple, I'll show you a very high-level description of what goes on. And if you want more details, you can go take a look at the papers or Wikipedia or anything like that. And so here's how it works. Let's suppose we've got some matrix W, which is the adjacency matrix. So Wij is just the adjacency between pixel I and pixel j. And then there's a special matrix, this diagonal matrix, that is just what's called the degree of the node for every vertex, how many other vertexes are connected to it, right? And so in this case, it's the sum, so it's a diagonal matrix, so the degree of pixel I is just the sum of all the affinities ij summed over all the j. And then what you can show is that the normalized cut cost can be written in using this simple expression, where this vector y is what's referred to as an indicator vector. So it's a vector that's got positive ones and negative ones as to whether, remember, we're cutting this into two parts, A and B. So it's a positive one if that point belongs to segment A, and it's a negative constant otherwise. All right. So to solve even that for Y is very difficult. But what you can do instead is, this is just written out here, we solve this eigenvector equation. And what that'll do is it'll solve for you for these Ys directly. But these y's, they're not going to be binary, you know, minus 1 or plus 1. They're going to have continuous values. And what you then do is you use that vector in order to solve for the partitioning. And this is related to spectral partitioning, for those of you familiar with those algorithms. And it's just an eigenvalue way of approximating the solution to this partitioning, because the full solution would be computationally too difficult.